Zoops, Commander Wolf 209 here, again with another figure review. First off, I want to tell you guys, I know you guys have been expecting reviews on Cad Bane, Heavy, and R7A7, and General Grievous, but, I'll still do reviews on them, but since I did get, the new wave of action figures, Ahsoka's wave of action figures, I will be doing reviews on them first, but, just clarifying that I will be doing those guys, doing reviews on those guys. Just these figures are so cool that I wanted to do the review on them first. Not saying that the others are not cool, they're really cool, but these, are by far my favorite. So, to get on to the review, this review is on the 2011 Wave 7 Ahsoka Tano, and that is season 3 outfit. For Ahsoka, it's got a bunch of details and accessories. It's quickly here. Let me just take off the lightsabers and take her off the stand real fast. I want to point out she does not have articulated ankles, but she does have articulated knees. She does not have articulated ankles. So I know I usually do that after the packaging, but just wanted to point that out real fast. So before I show you more of the figure, I will give you a quick look at the packaging it comes in. So up at the top, it's got a nice render of Ahsoka. It's got her in her battle pose. It's got the Star Wars logo. It is the free 30-day membership and station cash, and 450 station cash. She is figure number 44. On the back, it does have an actual picture of the action figure. Right there, it has got Ahsoka Tano, just a picture of Ahsoka. I think this may be backwards when I upload it, but if it is, then just tell me and I'll try to fix my camera for it to be normal, or I'll just do a different type of review to make it normal. It's also got other figures from its wave, such as Anakin, Aqua Droid, LS, and Commander Wolf. I do have all these guys except for LS. That's the one I need to find. But I do have all of those other guys. I will be doing a review on Wolf next, because I am Commander Wolf 209, so very cool figure. But yeah, I do have all those guys except for LS. I've heard a lot of great things about LS, so I did not get him. I did not find him there, so if you're thinking, like I didn't get him because he doesn't look as good, no. I would have gotten him no matter what, but LS looks awesome. I just didn't find him at the stores, the Walmart I go to, but there is a summary on the back I'll read to. Ahsoka grows in skill and experience as the war continues. Anakin's Padawan learns Jar Kai, which is double lightsabers. The challenging art of dueling with two lightsabers at the same time. Through hard work, Jedi training, and battlefield experience, young Ahsoka enhances her combat abilities and her skill with the Force. So that's the packaging. And if you, I know most people know how to do this, but if you do want to like get the packaging like this, where you can just pop it out and put it back in, all you have to do, there is slits on the bottom. What I do is just take scissors or a knife. Make sure you do this carefully. If you take a knife, just cut it out. I just take scissors like these and just cut a little window right there and pull it out. Pull out the figure, then put it back in without harming the packaging, just that bottom part. So, on to the figure and the accessories. So, I'll just say the articulation real fast. As I said at the beginning of the review, she does not have articulated ankles, but her articulation is a ball-jointed head, ball-hinged shoulders, ball-hinged elbows, swivel forearm, which is that kind of replaces the articulation for the wrists, swivel hips, swivel waist, hinged hips, and ball-hinged knees. The detail this figure has is amazing. It's very cool. Such as, I think this time they got the tail not the tail, but the kind of, I don't know what they are called, like the things on Ahsoka's head. I think they got them right this time. They didn't make them. Here, I'll get the other Ahsoka to do a little thing on, but I know she has grown up, and they have grown, but Ahsoka's little, like this one, it's like navy. The blue right there is navy, and it's just so, you gotta tilt it to make it fit on her head. It's just really weird and off. This figure, to me, is just horrible. Everything about this one, I liked it for the first couple of years when I got it for Christmas when I first started getting Clone Wars figures. I think that was about 3 years ago, but I did start collecting when I was like 3 or 4. But this figure, once I just realized this figure was so bad, but I just don't like it anymore. It's just horrible. I don't even want to really look at it. But this figure is way better because they actually made him fit on her shoulders. Like, you can do that, where, like, she can still look up and she can still look down. They actually fit on her now. On the back, it's a bunch of her skin is exposed on the back. Her armbands do not have as much detail because they do not have the little cuts in them to make diamonds. I think that would have been a little too challenging for Hasbro. But, She does come with two lightsabers. Oh, this is the other Ahsoka's one, but she does come with two lightsabers. One is her Shoto lightsaber. I think that's the name. Her Shoto lightsaber is a bit smaller. Same with the hilt. It is a bit smaller. She also does come with her normal lightsaber. Same lightsaber from the 2010 and 2009, I think. No lighter, no darker. I just think it's the same. She also does come with two non-ignited lightsaber hilts to put into her belt, which she does come with. The belt, I think, is very detailed. It's just got, this whole figure has got great detail and great sculpt. It's just so perfect. To tell you the truth, this was the only one I really wanted from the wave. If I could only get one, this is the one. Even though I am Commander Wolf 209, I would still just want this one. So you can put the lightsabers in her belt. They do have these little pegs on them. And there is a hole for the lightsaber hilt to go into. So you can do that. Her skirt is a fabric. A downfall and an upfall, a downfall and an upside to the figure is she does not have articulated ankles, but the 2009 and 2010 one do. And also, the upside is she does now have articulated elbows. The other one just had, her elbow was like just bent like that, and then it just stayed like that, and she only had swivel forearms. So this is a very cool figure. It got very great detail. It's got a little gold along her boots right there. She does have the diamond cut out on her pants all over her legs. Also on her, the gloves are a new sculpt. Not a new sculpt, but new paint job. To tell you the truth, I think this figure is way better. Way, way better. Like the Kit Fisto one, it's way better than the 2009 one. But, the accessories, as I said, it does come with the two unignited hilts. It does come with the two lightsabers, one Shoto, one normal. It does come with a Galactic Battle Game card. It's got a nice picture of Ahsoka right there. It comes with a stand and a die, which I do not have with me right now. But that is it for the figure. You may go to my channel, and I will upload Ahsoka, and then I will upload Cad Bane and Toto 360, along with Ahsoka. Even though it doesn't interwave, I will be uploading the figures just in random order. So my next review, well, you'll see Cad Bane next, but my next review from this wave will be on, it's going to be on Anakin Skywalker this time. Next time on this review. So, comment if you have any questions about this figure or what your favorite one is. So, comment, subscribe if you haven't, and may the Force be with you.